It is a part of the country that could definitely use the rain, but it's also going to make for a very wet track tonight here at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, California. Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the San Francisco 49ers. First quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
At their own 13-yard line.
First play, and Purdy wants to throw it. Gets this one to Juszczyk. Give him 3 there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
And the big guy catches the ball in the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Here's 2nd and 7. Here's the Pro Bowler, Christian McCaffrey.
And good yardage as he gets this one up to about the 23.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
An early test for this defense. Here we go on 3rd and inches. Pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. The Niners at 1-3 here in the early part of the year. They come in losers of 2 straight, so trying to turn things around here.
And you just mentioned 2 straight, and when you're talking about 2 games, that's nothing to panic about. They feel like they've been a little bit unlucky in the last couple. This is a club that's more than capable of turning things around, and I expect them to play really well here.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. It'll be 2nd down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Got it here at the 29 on 2nd and 8. First carry now for the LSU alum, Ty Davis Price. And he'll take this to the 32, a gain of about 3. You look at this Cowboy defense. This unit, 3rd best in the NFL in stopping the run.
Most of their challenges have come in the passing game, because against the run, they've been pretty darn good. Now you've got to figure out a way to slow down those receivers before they get downfield and maybe make a few more plays on the ball when it's in the air.
Purdy from the gun on 3rd down. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give him credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down.
You get a sense of what this game plan might be. They think they can take a few home run shots against this defense. They tried it there on the opening drive, but that falls incomplete.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away. 33 yards is the distance on the look over the football with a first and 10. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at about the 32. Now a man who's taken the reins with the Cowboys, it's Tony Pollard. And takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about 4. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays are just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
They go back to Pollard on second down. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. That time on the outside, pretty nice job as a cornerback to shed any would-be blockers and make the tackle.
Think about the praise we're giving him, what his coaches have given, but how about the respect he gets from his teammates to be a complete corner who doesn't just cover receivers, but also tackles ball carriers.
Second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. You look at this Niner defense. They've been excellent against the pass. The number 6 unit in the NFL.
You have to like the way that they played in the first part. They have to be very proud being a top 10 unit against the pass. Their goal, though, in this one, see if they can improve that ranking.
And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. 14 yards, good for a Cowboy first down. But one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, where that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
First down, and it's Pollard again. And a little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
On second down, it's Pollard. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sit through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Prescott, he's going to change things up here. Prescott from the gun on third. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
I don't see more than trying to get him to football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
pass is going to be fielded defensively. And remember, this is a live football. He's past the 30. He's past the 30. And we're going to stop play here at least momentarily. It looks like there is a 49er who's in some discomfort. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. Here's Purdy on first and 10. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. Micah Parsons showing off that elite athleticism as he gets the sack.
Well, that's an excellent way to get the pass rush activated. The first sack of the game for them comes on the first play of the drive, and it makes it very tough for the opponent to pick up a first down now, playing behind the sticks.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go.
Purdy will set up to throw it here. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down.
And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Here is third down and 4.
A handoff, McCaffrey running right, and he won't get to the marker. He's a yard short. A pickup of 3, it leaves him with 4th and 1.
They'll go for it. Here's Purdy.
And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and it'll be a turnover on downs. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Pollard will take it up the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Talanoa Hufanga, a first-time All-Pro last year, up to make the tackle.
All runners count on their eyes to find the gaps and creases, to find open space. There is absolutely none on that one. Totally swallowed up on that play.
Second down, Pollard again.
A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. They just get the playoff. Now Prescott.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And the 49ers are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. We sort of suspected that the elements might wreak havoc on both of these offenses, and that's been the case. No points on either side as this drive begins with a first down. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
At the 17-yard line.
Back to throw, Purdy. He gets this one to Davis Price. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Short completion, just 4 yards. Third and seven now. We're scoreless after one. The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a third down coming up. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Here's Purdy now on third and goal.
Eluding the pressure right.
And that is incomplete. Boy, did everything but hold on to it. But a nice play defensively, and now it brings up fourth down.
I know this offense was expecting to do big things, but it certainly hasn't turned out that way, at least not through the first 3 drives. They're definitely going to have to put their heads together and start concocting some offense that'll move the ball downfield.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Returnable here from the 38. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And they will take over first and 10.
At their own 43-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
They go back to Pollard on second down. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and 2. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he will have a Cowboys first down, and comfortably so, as he gets 5 there on 3rd and 1.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, 3 plays, all 3 short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
In motion left goes Cooks. Gonna run again here with Pollard. Free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And down he goes, taking it inside. inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
84 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
He had his eyes on the end zone once he hit the secondary, but they're finally able to slow him down.
Yeah, and I've got to look at this one from the defensive point of view. You just mentioned finally able to slow him down. They've got to figure out a way to make that at the point of attack, at the line of scrimmage, because once he gets through, he's shredding them.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. On the ground with Vaughn. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Deuce Vaughn, his third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Cowboys post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter.
They go I formation. Fullback leads the way for the touchdown. Sort of a lost art, isn't it?
It really is, but sometimes when you're able to bring it back and use it against other teams, they're not prepared for it. They haven't seen it in a while, and now you gain an advantage, and we just saw that advantage result in a touchdown.
The point after through the raindrops, up and good, and that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Yeah, that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. It hasn't gone particularly well for them. That's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic, meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe you hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
Purdy now to throw. Connects with Kittle underneath. They'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
The Niners on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 4. Throwing here, Purdy. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Leighton Vander Esch. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
From the 24 now, here's 2nd down and 8. Here's Pollard again. They'll be brought down at the 21 after a pickup of 4.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back can run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
On third down, it's Pollard. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down.
Now that was a big time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let them get anywhere near it.
And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. Meeting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he is going to have the Cowboys first down. They go for it on fourth and two, and it's a gain of six.
Surprised at all that they went with a fullback there?
Not at all, because it harkened back to the days where we watched these games almost in black and white, right? The stocky guy, the strong guy, the powerful guy with leg drive, give him the football, and even if the blocking isn't...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Cowboys have taken a 2-touchdown lead now.
A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment. That allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through, and it's now 14 to nothing. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Yeah, they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line.
The Niners take over first and 10.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
First down, here's Mitchell. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain. Second down.
Suspected it was a power play up the middle coming at them, and boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
Second down and 8. Davis Price gets this one out of the gun. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now, the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Here's Purdy. A throw left sideline, falls incomplete.
This is a half where not just the coverage, but the entire defense is setting the tone in this game.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Out of the gun, Purdy. That is incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Purdy. And this one is incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Jake Moody for the 49ers field goal. A 38-yard attempt.
And this is going to be no good. He misses it off to the left, and this will remain a two-touchdown game.
Wow, that qualifies as a bad miss because anything inside of 40 should be automatic. That's a big mistake right there.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. From the 35, back to work on second and four. Lamb will go in motion. Second down, Pollard again. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 125 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
A shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry. And they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
Second and five. It'll be a handoff to Pollard, and he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he will have a Cowboys first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 1.
3rd and 1, who are you going to call? Not the scat back. You go with the big man. Hand him the ball and let him get upfield and pick up a first down.
All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10. Play fake. Here's Prescott. Out to it. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. It's the former number 4 overall pick, Cleland Farrell, that got in there to bring him down. That's a step in the right direction defensively here because you're facing this sizable deficit. They're going to need more plays like that. A good sack, though. Good effort there.
And what you're hoping is, as you said, a step in the right direction. And that means it's something to build on. So you get the first one, and hopefully that can ignite them. And now they can make a few more plays and get back into this game.
And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final play of the half, Prescott. This one thrown deep for Schoonmaker. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And he will be out of bounds with no time remaining on what will be the final action of this first half. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And, Charles, they've got the lead. I would imagine the overall halftime tone was a positive one, but what do you think the talking points were in the locker room?
Well, if there were 3 talking points at the half, partner, all of them were about turnovers because they were pretty loose with the ball. Otherwise, this lead could be even bigger. Now, I don't think that they overly harped on it, but I think they told him, guys, if you want to keep calling those plays that are exciting, you've got to take care of the ball. Otherwise, we may have to dial things back a little bit.
The big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
They go back to Pollard on 2nd down. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
shotgun to give to Pollard. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. 147 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A give to Pollard running left. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
Here now, second and 4. Now a give here to Pollard. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 7 yards there and a first down.
A great run by Pollard, and runs like that have had us anticipating a breakout season from him for years. And it finally arrived in 2022. Dallas gave him more run, and he had his first 1,000-yard season despite receiving less than 200 touches.
Cooks motions to the left. Here's Pollard. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough at run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
A run for Pollard, and for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Off the play fake, Prescott. He'll buy some time right. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. That one goes for 30 yards.
Well, that was a pretty good time for his first catch of the ball game, and it turned into a huge play as well. He's certainly not been a central part of this passing game so far in this one, but he made his presence felt there. A big pickup on third down.
And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Taking it within an eyelash, dropped at the 1. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Pollard is in. Touchdown, Dallas. Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. And it is now 21 to nothing.
Makes the score Cowboys 21, 49ers nothing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
Let's go. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
Here's Mitchell now to kick off the drive.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. Interior of that line blocked really well on that run, but also the two tight ends, they blocked well too.
Not only have they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Purdy. Dancing to his left. And this one in. Receiver.
I'm sure it was a tough halftime trying to figure out some strategy to get things going, trailing by a lot when they went into the locker room. He's just trying every avenue to spark his team here to begin the third quarter. Not a lot going on that play, though.
Here's second and 10. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Now a second and 10. Hand off right side, Davis Price.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Purdy now to throw off the play action.
And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack.
Osa Odighizawa
able to record his fifth sack of the season.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner. And I don't think with three scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And taken right at the 35. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
At their own 44-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They're just looking for more of the same. Great first half so far, good second half. And well, sometimes, I guess, maybe, Charles, these coaches, they don't have to tell these guys much when they're rolling like they're rolling right now.
You're exactly right. I've heard stories of some of the best coaches in our time or any time having grabbed their staffs at halftime and said, guys, they're playing really well. Don't go in there and give them a whole lot of stuff. Just pat them on the back, and essentially the speech at halftime is, let's go, guys, and that's it.
Yeah, no one's upset the apple cart so far.
Here's a second and 5.
Gonna run again here with Pollard.
And he'll get it down here to the 43.
198 yards rushing for him now as he closes in on a 200-yard night.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down.
Flashy little move, but unable to reach the 40. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end-of-the-half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game, and with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
They'll wind up losing three here on the play, and it'll be a third and about 13.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play, but no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
They toss it down to Pollard.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Here's Brian Anger now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat.
And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. The first down screen pass, good for five.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid gain.
Second down, here's Davis Price.
And down he'll go at the 25. And they're going to speed things up here.
First and 10 at the 25-yard. Now Purdy, he's going to change the look here.
Back to throw now on first down. Flushed out right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24.
Purdy looking to throw.
And his throw's going to be incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
The offense on third down tonight, it's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This will be third and forever. Looking to throw. Purdy. Oh, an ill-advised throw there, and it's intercepted.
picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And, Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them, and they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
They run straight ahead here with Pollard, and he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and it'll be second and very short.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
Second down, Pollard again. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. Give him 2 yards. That sets him up first and goal. Hate to be blunt, but it is just continuing to prove to be the case that this O-line is manhandling this D-line right now.
They deserve to roll up their sleeves and show up their biceps because they're doing exactly what you just described, manhandling the defensive front. They've got the leverage. They are powering through, and they're controlling this game.
They'll run with Pollard.
And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Tony Pollard with his third touchdown so far, number 13 now on the year.
And the Cowboys look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter.
PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And this is a situation where, as a head coach, you're just saying, what else could go wrong? Let's get it all out of our system, please. This has been a sloppy game throughout. The execution has been lacking. A lot of mistakes, both mental and physical. And here's a big play that goes by the wayside.
Purdy now on second down. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Back to throw. Purdy.
And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far.
Picked up by Leighton Van Der Esch. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Now Prescott going to change the play.
Good. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
They go back to Pollard on second down.
And look at this, for the second straight play, the 49er defense drops him for a loss. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. Finally, defensively, they have a little clip to show positive for actually stopping him running the football.
It's been a really long night for them, hasn't it? So they got a little bit of a win there, but let's face it, the vision that he's had running the football has carried his feet to the open spaces and to big yardage all night long.
So a little tardy getting everyone set, and the clock hits zero before they could snap it.
Yeah, you can take your time and use the clock and try and get set up, but once it gets near 5 seconds, that's when you often hear a quarterback yelling, hurry, hurry, to make sure everybody's ready to get the snap off.
And there's Cooks in motion right.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
Live with that with this late lead in the fourth quarter. That's one of the few things that's gone wrong.
You're exactly right. This one was well in hand. That kick there was more for cosmetics, you know, to add to their score. Not getting it, that shouldn't harm them at all.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. First throw now for the backup, Allen. And his first throw since coming in is incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Second and 10. On play action, Allen. This one caught by Kittle. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
Throwing on first down is Allen. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. Gets it out wide to Davis Price. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Let's go.
The offense on third down tonight, a pretty anemic, a very anemic, 1 for 9 thus far. This will be third and a mile. Now Allen, taking a shot for Samuel. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes, no points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. One final try here for Allen. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And he is going to be out of bounds a mile away from that yellow line. And that will become a turnover on downs. So they've gone for it twice now on fourth down of this game, and both times unsuccessful.
I wish we could hear the headsets now between the head coach and the offensive coordinator. Now that they're 0 for 2, if they get into a third situation, head coach might say, hey, you got anything for this one? Might get radio silence back.
So the drive's going to start with Pollard. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, from my vantage point, that's just one bad play by the offensive line and a running back who's had a lot of good ones tonight.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean he's not going to be ticked off, nor is the offensive line, because to me it's a lot like a no-hitter, right? Pitcher's throwing a no-hitter, gives up a hit late. You're so close to accomplishing everything you want and don't quite get it done. They'll come back with a vengeance on the next play.
13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out. Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces, and I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
From the 47, it's second and 5. There
we go, kill, kill.
A give running right is Vaughn.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, you know they had a third down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10.
Hey, here we go. Here we go, going to 54. Wide in. Switch.
On first down, they go back to Vaughn again.
And he'll bring this one inside the 35. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
That's right, Paul. Totally a penalty.
They are pushed back 5 yards by the delay of game, 2nd and 8.
Go, go, go. Get out there. Get out there.
Again, a run with Vaughn.
Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. Running right, it's Pollard. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Cowboy first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Vaughn on first and 10. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. They'll toss this out right for Vaughn.
And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set him back for second down. Throwing here, Prescott. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end, but now this game is over.
So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys, and this was truly a total team effort, Charles, on both sides of the ball.
No, they absolutely pitched.